Greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Kingdom Hearts Rechain of Memories playthrough, and we begin with a pouting Donald.
Hopeless Donald. That's what we call
him. What did you do to make Donald sad, Johnny?
We accidentally put Mick in the beginning of his name.
I am sorry that we've been pronouncing slights as slates.
I've been calling him slights.
We've been all calling him slates. It's supposed to be slight. You know, as in sleight of hand.
Slight my deck and slate.
Hey, I see 8 and I see SL next to it. I'm going to call it a slate.
Same difference.
Exactly. I think.
And me? I'm looking for Riku. He was with the king when the door closed.
Just in case you didn't play the first game.
The most important memories.
Now you don't have to.
Are we in Castle Oblivion or A&A meeting?
No, it's AA.
AA. Alcoholics.
What if?
Yeah, you said A&A.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Well, Alcoholics and Anonymous?
And Anonymous.
We are one. Divided.
Was it Ermac?
Yeah.
Are you telling me you're not Larxene?
I love Larxene's voice actress in this. She nails the role perfectly, really.
I think what intrigues me
Who voices
more
her?
Is...
I don't know who, but I love it.
Maybe
you could tell from the tone alone that you get bitch.
Exactly.
Yeah. Maybe she's like Wendy Lee. She's right. In everything. She's in everything Japan.
He held on. Why does that sound like she's been in a 200 man bukkake?
I never got the point of the feelers though.
What feelers?
Yeah.
Double horns.
Yeah, I guess that's the most obvious one, but you know, I feel like, you know, because the whole electricity thing based, she's looking for a signal or something like that.
Are you expecting her to have a fried afro?
I kind of.
Yeah, that'd be great.
But wait, what if she puts her hand on an energy ball?
Oh, it just goes straight up?
Yeah.
And now we're straight up alfalfa in this son of a bitch.
Alfalfa the psycho.
Or maybe if she turns into a heartless, then she has those. But instead of them turning black, they just stay yellow.
When a person dies, they do become a nobody and a heartless, so. Not dies. When their heart's taken by the darkness, they become a heartless and a nobody, so that's going
to
be a stretch.
It's a kid's game, so you had to say that. You can't say die. Ugh.
Bullshit.
I can't. That's no time for a nap.
So maybe oh no. That I really am losing my memory. And, by the way, I'm spoiling the end of this game because fuck you guys. At the end of the game, they all die from Alzheimer's.
But whatever they were, but hey, they still have each other.
What was it, stage 4?
Duh. Or else, I don't stage. No, you're right. I think that's what would have happened if they stayed here any longer. They would have forgotten their motor skills.
It's a little person.
We're holding the Oath Keeper the entire time. Why isn't this reflected on our Keyblade?
Because we don't have the card.
What?
We don't have the card.
But we still have the damn Keyblade.
Because Chain of Memories, deal with it.
That does bring up an interesting, different kind of point, though. Sora amassed all those sort of keychains and whatnot. Why don't we have them anymore in like a little collectible box?
Or just put them in a little satchel?
Oh shit, the darkness! Am
I right? No, it's the void.
Kyrie? You know it, Sora. Hey!
It's not Exodeath.
It may as well be.
Alright, what about this person?
Who the fuck is that?
Blonde emo.
What? Blonde emo.
Blonde emo?
How'd you get emo?
You're just
well, like, I mean, don't get me wrong, Ellie, you're perfectly right, but what exactly...
how do you get that even though you're right?
Yeah, but it's like, how exactly would you draw that comparison? The fucking hair over the eye?
For the most part.
Blonde emo?
Not only that, but it's like the hairstyle in general.
So that very much dictates that somebody's an emo rather than poorly groomed.
How long has she been in the castle?
Hmm.
I mean, damn, that must have been a long time she's been
okay,
in there.
Okay, so this is
And so Johnny stepped into the light and re-edited his deck.
I stepped
you
into
got,
the light.
Oh, you got the barrel spider card, you fucker. That's the one enemy card I can't seem to come across.
So this is in between recording sessions. I did a bit of grinding in the Olympus Coliseum, so I got a second cloud card, and I got the barrel spider card.
What should we call it? Barrel spider's fast reload, as we've already mentioned in a previous recording.
By fast reload, we means that when you recharge the counter, you have that animation that plays when your cards are reshuffling.
Yeah.
Barrel spider skips that.
Oh yeah, that alone helps in speed duels.
They're convenient.
Yeah,
convenient,
it is.
It helps.
Well, this looks familiar.
You were saying something about Olympus Coliseum, right?
Yeah, what should we call it? Not Olympus Coliseum, the Olympia. As somebody mentioned in the comments, they all Keyblades have different kind of swing speeds, recovery speeds, and what have you. The Olympia is slow but powerful, and it comes up with a great finish.
Yes.
One of the things you want to keep in mind when you organize your deck is what card goes best to what one of the three slots you have. Mind you, in the heat of combat, that's not necessarily going to be optimal because there's going to be times when your card breaks and your combo gets fucked up or something like that. So organize your decks like that to keep in mind like whichever card has like the powerful combo finish. But don't swear religiously by it, you know?
So we're playing Yu-Gi-Oh still.
In a way.
We're playing Yu-Gi-Oh the entire game.
Yu-Gi-Oh with Yu-Gi-Oh cards. By the way, Wonderland is one of the few areas that shows a new gimmick within some of the worlds.
By that, I mean hitting a purple flower to get a door to open.
That's all there is to it.
Yep.
The hell?
That's it.
Time sync.
Yeah, that's all it is. There are some doors that are blocked by vines. You look for the purple flower inside the room, break it open, and that's it.
Why aren't you going against Heartless?
Because at this point, I already grinded enough in the Olympus Coliseum to not waste any more time with Heartless. Although I will be showing off some new... Because we're actually going to get new Heartless in this world.
Oh, finally.
You know, the ones that we didn't see in Kingdom Hearts 1.
Right.
Did Japan get them in their final mix?
Yes. Yeah.
Bastards.
These are exclusive to Chain of Memories.
I still don't get the whole over-exaggerating to open a chest.
Ooh, but, I mean, stop!
If Link can get that dynamic camera angle... And...
Why can't Sora?
Yeah.
No, that's because he's getting a very important item.
Sora's fucking show off.
We just got Stop.
Sora's show off. Stop is one of those cards I never use alone.
Yes.
But god damn, it's a beautiful some slates.
Wait.
One of my personal favorite tricks to use with Stop is to combine that with my Cloud cards. Yeah. This way Cloud has a constant 3-hit cross slash.
Cross slash plus.
Which no, would... cross slash plus is different. It's cross slash plus is where Cloud singles out an enemy and uses it.
Oh, it's cross slash minus. Okay.
It's cross slash...
Cross slash.
1.5. Cross slash cross.
Okay.
Basically, I use Stop Magic and then perform the cross slash. This way I have both my Cloud cards, and Cloud gets in 3 good hits unless the enemy flies.
That's a pretty good way of doing it.
It helps me avoid that nonsense.
Just a few questions I noticed in the comment section. I don't remember exactly who asked them, but yes, we are doing Riku's reverse rebirth. We kind of need to for plot purposes.
Are you doing that or am I doing it?
I'm doing that.
Okay.
Well, of course, he's still playing Chain of Memories, so it's still part of the game.
Okay.
And you guys were asking for specific slights, like lethal frame.
Oh, that's a beautiful fucking combination. Oh my god, I think that's Chain of Memories, because I don't remember seeing that in all...
It is. No, Lethal Frame is exclusive to Chain of Memories.
That's what I was thinking, because I don't remember seeing that in the goddamn game. I used that. Holy Jesus Christ.
Wait, where are those?
These are
Creeper Plants.
Yeah, these are Creeper Plants.
They're annoying in the sense of they like to play a lot of 6 cards.
Yeah, so they can break your shit without you even knowing, so...
Goofy, on the other hand, just goes, fuck you, I weed whack.
So this is Cross Slash, which you get for combining 2 Cloud cards. If you combine 3 Cloud cards, you get Omnis Slash, which is one of my favorite moves actually to do in the Game Boy Advance version of the game.
It's only because it helps them sweep, but the only thing is that I prefer the Cross Slash Plus combo I used, but only because it saves me some time and energy. Yeah. Fire! A 0.
No, you have to say it like Beavis.
No.
I don't remember how
another picture well taken.
I don't remember how accurate Omni Slash was in Rechain of Memories, but
it was 3 hits normal. But yeah. In this game, it gets a sort of command prompt.
Yeah.
Basically, you have to land 5 hits. You have to land up to 5 hits, but if you press triangle incorrectly, the slate cancels.
Yeah. So you get the potential for more damage, but you got to have more. You have to have more involvement with the attack. In the Game Boy Advance version, it was automatic 3 hits.
Yeah, but however, Cloud would usually miss sometimes.
I disagree. He was pretty accurate with Meathwolt when I ever used him.
Oh, for you?
Well, that's why I disagree.
Like, yeah. Sure.
But you're saying that was for you. We're talking about in his case.
That's why I disagreed.
Exactly.
Okay, then. Jesus.
All praise to Keyblade.
Was it God?
God had the biggest heart of all.
I was expecting more, actually.
What was the shape of Mickey's head?
Heart-shaped Mickey's head, I can see that. Unless it means he has cancer.
You have these presents you can open up.
More stops.
Yeah. I get a lot of them in this world, spoiler warning.
Now, see, as somebody also pointed out, too, one of the strategic things you can do with this with those cards is you can easily set them up in the front slate of the deck and then use, like, 2 other 9 cards or something like that.
Yeah.
And you can easily... And you can easily work around the low number of the card itself, so you don't have to worry about that. The only problem is, however, and ironically enough, with Lethal Frame as is, when it comes to the Lethal Frame, they stop automatically, like the enemies get stunned while in the duration for so long as you can land that initial hit.
Yeah.
Or the initial casting, so you can easily land it real easily and not have to worry about it getting broken.
Another thing about Lethal Frame is that it inflicts stop on even those that are immune to stop to begin with.
Yikes.
It's always this music that plays.
Because we have a situation going on.
Wait, what? What? But is this one specific track, though?
Last time it was CSI Wonderland. Now it's NCIS Wonderland. Except, you know, no Navy. WCIS?
Was she read the Miranda rights?
There's no Miranda rights. The Queen's Miranda rights is fuck you, Alice.
You have the right to remain arrested.
The evidence is, I forgot. There's your evidence. Alzheimer's? What the fuck is that? Is that a taco?
You have the right to remain arrested. Anything you say can and will be used against you in the court of me. You have no right to an attorney. If you can afford an attorney, we will kill him.
We will immediately revoke that right.
We will then kill him.
Yo, Johnny, have you ever seen the Avatar, the Last Bender episode where they were holding the Avatar on trial?
I never watched an episode of Avatar.
Oh, you. Anyway.
Oh, no.
Anyway, there's this one episode where the Earthbender guy who wanted to try the Avatar on trial, he wanted to enforce a justice system, but he just used the phrase, just us. In other words, you tell me your side, I listen, and I decide whether or not it's fair or not. Which means he's pretty much a hung jury. Sora, why did you stop it? We don't have evidence! What's evidence?
Hey, John.
Uh-oh, straight flush.
Hey, John.
What's up?
Remember those Mickey Mouse head pizzas that we had?
No.
Really?
I don't.
Jesus, I remember those. The ears were big as shit.
Was it just three deep dish pizzas joined together? Hey, look, a good Mickey Mouse head. $99.99.
Fuck.
Anyway, card battle. There's nothing to worry about, really.
Well, I wouldn't be so sure about that. If you don't have consistently high-level cards, they will break your shit repeatedly. Because I came here first instead of doing everything else with my fall, it hit me pretty hard.
I think.
Oh, Cloud cuts the deck. Thank you, Agonat.
Two Goofies will give you Goofy Tornado level 2. It's pretty much the same attack, only it's more powerful. And
by the way, Goofy is different in this game. I remember now. Goofy in the original would pretty much just do like a charge attack, and Goofy Tornado was level 3.
Yeah, but in this game, since we have 3D,
he's always doing Goofy Tornado, he's doing and he's super attack. Awesome for yeah. it.
He's always doing Goofy.
Goofy was definitely given a buff.
He's always doing Goofy
game.
Things.
Yeah.
I'd be remiss to think he was doing something different, Ed. Johnny just gets poked and prodded like a cow at the goddamn farm.
Oh, yes!
But this cow is angry.
Oh, yes!
I believe Goofy will home in on whatever you have targeted.
No, he circles.
No, you know, he circles, but he also has a tendency of... Because I tried this, like... He circles no matter what you do, but if you have something locked on, he will veer towards that enemy while still circling. But locking on is actually something I rarely do in this game.
I can agree to that, too. I just forget that I have it.
Well, they switched the lock
on. Oh, Lordy, get that out of there!
The lock-on button is switched in this game, because they use the L1 and R1 buttons to shuffle around the cards. They switched it to R2, which I don't always remember immediately.
Yeah. This is another. This is like carry armor, one of those things that improves your card strokes, but I never notice it.
Yeah, I don't bother with the card soldier card. That's two drinks.
Two drinks?
Yeah, someone made a drinking game.
Oh, fuck.
Take a shot every time you say card. Are you dead yet?
Wait, in the game in
I like that punch, shut up.
Wait, in the game in general, or just in this world?
Or in our commentary.
In our commentary.